Welcome to this crash course where you will learn how to use REST APIs with Dart and Flutter. I created this course because REST APIs are used everywhere in today's web. And if you master the basics of the Dart HTTP library, you can write Flutter apps that can tap into thousands of web APIs. So in this crash course, we will build a simple but completely functional coronavirus tracker application in Flutter. This application is just a simple dashboard that shows all the cases of coronavirus worldwide. To build this app, we will use the nCoV 2019 REST API. This is a free API that is relatively simple to use, but from a technical point of view, it will give us plenty of things to talk and learn about. So here's a list of topics that are covered in this crash course. We will start with a short introduction to REST, what it is and how it works. Then we will see an overview of the nCoV 2019 Health API. This is used to fetch statistics about the coronavirus outbreak around the world. We will talk about API keys and access tokens, what they are and how to use them. And we will learn how to use REST Client, which is a VS Code extension that you can use to send HTTP requests and view the response directly in Visual Studio Code. After that, we will build this application from scratch. As a starting point, we will design a REST API service in Dart and learn how to use the HTTP package to make requests and handle responses. And we will also learn how to read and parse the JSON response data from our API. Then we will build a single page UI using the API service that we have created. We will then see how to combine multiple API requests into a single response by using futures. And we will use a refresh indicator to get updated data from the API. We will add error handling, which is a very important topic when designing robust applications. Finally, we will see how to use shared preferences to cache API responses so that the data is saved locally on device and is available offline. This course is all about mastering the basics. While we will build only a single page application, you will get all the knowledge that you need to work with REST APIs in Dart and use them to build slick looking UIs in Flutter. And I'm confident that by the end of this course, you will be able to build Flutter apps that connect with any other REST API that you want to use. Not only that, but we will talk about app architecture as well. Architecture is a very important topic, and I'll make sure that we build this app following best practices. Now, this course will be divided into separate videos and follow the topics in the order that I have described. And you will have access to the full source code for each lesson. So, what are the prerequisites? In order to take this course, you should already be familiar with the Dart language. If you are not, I recommend that you start with my introduction to Dart, which is available as a playlist on my YouTube channel. I also assume that you already have Flutter installed on your system. We will use Visual Studio Code to build our application, so you should have it installed and configured for Flutter development. And if you prefer to use Android Studio, then that's fine also. Finally, you should already have some knowledge of the most common Flutter widgets, as well as the difference between stateful and stateless widgets. With that said, if you want to learn how to build maintainable Flutter apps using REST APIs, then this course is for you. By the way, part of this course will be available for free here on YouTube. But if you want to get the full content, then you have to buy the course on Teachable. So just to be completely clear, this is what you get on each platform. The free course on YouTube will include roughly half of the topics that I've already described, so that you can get all the way to writing a REST API service with the HTTP library in Dart. On the other hand, the paid course will include all these other topics and will show you how to build the application UI and connect it to the API service that we will build in the first part. The paid course also comes with premium support. This means that I aim to answer all questions within 24 hours. And I will also keep the paid course up to date with the latest Flutter and Dart packages. So to recap, you'll get a few lessons for free here on YouTube, but the full course will be available on Teachable. I don't know exactly how long the final course will be, but it will likely have between 2 and 3 hours of content. And because it is a crash course, it aims to get you up to speed with REST APIs in a short amount of time. By the way, some of you have been asking if I plan to publish the course on Udemy, and the answer is that for the moment, this is not planned. Instead, I will publish all the course content on Teachable, and I think I'll be able to offer a better teaching experience on this platform. And I plan to use Teachable not just for this course, but for future courses as well. This way, I'll be able to sell multiple courses for a discounted price in a single bundle, and this is not something that is possible with Udemy. You can find this new course at courses.codewithandrea.com, and as I publish this video, it is on sale with an introductory price of $12. This already includes the first chapter of the course with an introduction to REST APIs. I'm aiming to add new content on a weekly basis, and the course should be complete within the next couple of months. So if you enroll today, you can get the course and all future updates for $12. But once again, the price will go up as I add more content. So today is the best time to purchase my course. And you can do this by going to courses.codewithandrea.com and pressing the enroll button. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.